Hello, I'm Ed Kordick with the Iowa Farm Bureau, and this is one of the videos of the video series for the Iowa Commodity Challenge. In this presentation, I'll be talking to you about futures hedging. When we're talking about futures hedging, we're talking about doing an equal and opposite thing in the futures market than we're going to do later on in the cash market anyway. So it's not increasing risk, it's basically transferring risk to the futures market. You can also think about it as a farmer hedging by taking an action now in the futures market that they're going to take on later in the cash market. So we're not at all increasing risk, we're just kind of fast forwarding a decision into the futures market that we're going to have to do later on in the cash market anyway. This is one of my favorite diagrams that talks about the markets that need to be tracked in a futures transaction as a hedge. We've got cash, futures, and basis that we can track from the standpoint of at the beginning date and all the way to the end date and all the way to the results. So as we go through these examples, you've got cash on the one column, futures we'll keep track of in the middle column, and then basis on the far right column. Now, what we're doing now in hedging on a sold hedge is we're gonna sell now in that box at the beginning date for something later on that we're gonna do later on in the cash market anyway. So keep that in mind as we go through this video when we do the hedge examples. First of all, I'd like to talk a little bit about basis to define it. It's the difference between cash price in your local area and the futures price. So it's going to be influenced by many, many factors. And if you can think about your own local cash price, it's influenced by the local supply demand, whether there's a train coming in that the elevator needs to fill, maybe the ethanol market needs, you know, some more bushels, so that's going to make basis tighter. So it's very influenced by local supply demand. Futures prices are influenced by worldwide events. Local basis is influenced by local supply and demand. The calculation for futures or for basis is basically taking that cash price, as we see in this example, maybe $3.10 for corn, subtracting a futures price of $3.55, and then we would get 45-cent basis. So it's always very important, especially in the state of Iowa, we often have negative basis. Sometimes we have a little bit of a positive basis, but as long as you take that cash minus futures, you're going to end up with the right sign on that, end up on that basis. And basis is that difference between the local cash price and the futures price. And in this graph, I just show it's that space between the lines, isn't it? The red line is the futures, the blue line is cash, and basis is well labeled there. It's the difference between those two lines. So let's think about it as that. It's the simple difference, mathematical difference between futures and cash. Let me tell you a story, an example future story, where we're going to use a hedge. It's November after harvest, and we've got a goal for 5,000 bushels. Maybe it's our first 5,000 bushel that we're going to market, and we want to market it in late February. So we'd like some price protection, and the estimated basis for that late February time frame versus March futures is 30 cents under. So that's cash under March futures of 30 cents under. Historically, we have some history that tells us that's a good basis to estimate. We look at March corn futures and they're at $4. So what would happen if the price goes higher or lower? And I'd like to illustrate in these examples that it really doesn't matter on this first hedge whether the price goes lower or higher. It really matters what that basis ends up being. And in these examples, we'll keep basis equal to what we estimated. And just a note, these hedging examples don't include commissions and interest on margin, which would be some marginal costs you'd want to consider in real life. So there's our T diagram again, and we're going to look at the market going lower in this first example. The setup is my goal is $3.70. I hedge or sell one March corn futures contract at $4, expecting basis to be 30 cents under at the end of the transaction. So I've got a good basis history. I estimate that basis history at 30 cents under, and my goal is that $3.70. Now, in this T diagram, as I explained earlier, I can fast forward through time. And then I get to late February where I have actually stored those bushels for a while. And now the price has done something, hasn't it? It's gone lower, and it's gone lower by 45 cents in each market. So the cash market went lower by 45 cents away from my goal. The futures market went lower by 45 cents. But if you think about it this way, that futures column is a temporary substitute for what I'm doing in the cash market. So if I sold it at $4 and I bought it back when I sold that cash corn at $3.55, selling high and buying low, that's actually a profit in the futures account. And as you can see in the results row there, that makes up for that cash loss. So that 45 cent gain in futures, in this case with the market going lower, makes up for that 45 cent loss in the cash market. So how do we figure the net on a transaction like this? Well, this is the same visual that you saw in the blown up version on the slide before, and I can figure it two ways. I can take my sold cash position at $4 less what actual basis ends up being, which in this case was the 30 cents, and that ends up being $3.70. Or many people look at it this way too, where I sold the cash at 325. That's the check I got from the elevator in late February. I add in the futures gain and I get my $3.70 either way. Now I prefer the top way to figure out your net hedge because it doesn't focus me in on whether I make or lose money on the futures account, which really doesn't matter. But either way you figure it, you're going to get $3.70 for the net position. Again, without considering commissions and interest on margin, which would diminish it by a little bit. Let's move the market higher, but let's keep the story the same. I still want a $3.70 net cash position in late February, so I'm going to store the corn, and I'm going to sell one March corn futures at $4. That's one contract or 5,000 bushels at the Board of Trade. The estimated basis being 30 cents. So I take that action. In late February, the market in this case has gone higher. It's gone higher by 40 cents. It's 410 in the cash market, so I sell the corn in the cash market and get a check for $4.10 for that 5,000 bushel. Immediately and without delay, I buy back that March corn contract. And I want to emphasize in this example, immediately and without delay. On all hedging examples, you want to get out of that hedge position as close in time proximity as you can to when you sold that cash. If, for example, in this case, I sold the cash corn at $4.10 and listened to some market advisor that said, well, the market's going to go lower, I better not delay offsetting that futures contract or else I'm going to be speculating on futures contract movement. So I want to do it immediately and as close as possible to when I sold that cash, and then I can figure out my net hedge. In this case, it's $4 less the 30 cent basis or $3.70, which is the same calculation we did with the earlier example. Or if I want to look at it in a profit loss method on the futures contract, it's $4.10 that I got from the elevator less the 40 cents I lost in futures, and I would get $3.70. So in this case, am I upset? Well, if you go back to my first example, I said this is the first 5,000 bushel that I sold. And I'm a very strong advocate of scaling in sales if we're going to use futures or cash forward contracts or hedge to arrives. So if this is the first 5,000 of, let's say, 50,000 bushel, can you see that the market going higher is better for my net position on all my bushels? So don't worry so much about whether you make or lose money on futures. It's your entire position. And as we say in another of these video series, it's total profitability that we're going for. So what are the key points of this short presentation? The cash, futures, and basis markets can be tracked in those futures hedges. A futures hedge is going to work whether the market goes higher or lower. It doesn't matter on those particular bushels. And I want to remind you, or I guess say for the first time, that many people don't use futures directly, but if you're using a hedge to arrive contract directly, these are the exact same mechanics that you will see in your hedge to arrive through your elevator or processor. Again, my name's Ed Kordick with the Iowa Farm Bureau, and this is one of the videos in support of the Commodity Challenge.